Hello dear students, welcome to today's class. Today we will be talking about summative one. You know you are going to appear for term one, summative one, in which two types of questions will be set. One is objective type and other one is subjective type. Objective questions carry 20 marks and subjective questions carry 20 marks, total 40 marks. MCQ questions will be set for 20 marks. So, this is very important for you. Today we will be talking about that MCQ questions. The first topic is the priceless gift. Let's have a discussion about this topic, okay? The first question is, the writer went to a vegetarian restaurant on a dash. Sunday, Friday, Saturday, Monday. Which is the correct answer? Yes, the correct answer is Saturday. Next question, her eyes were large. They had a sad expression. Here, they refers to dash. The restaurant staff, the people in the restaurant, the girl's face, the girl's eyes. Correct answer, the girl's eyes. Question number 3. Who did the girl ask about the writer? The waiter, the cashier, the customer, her friend. Correct answer, the cashier. Question number 4. Who did the writer ask about the girl? The cashier, the waiter, the customer, the manager. Answer is the waiter. Next question, question number 5. Which day was her payday? Very easy question. Answer is Saturday. Question number 6. Why was Mrs. Bethy worried? Her son had died. Maggie was late, unable to make living. There was no letter from her son. Correct answer is D. There was no letter from her son. Question number 7. Who was Maggie's guardian? Her father, her mother, her brother, the writer. Answer is her brother. Question number 8. The writer felt Maggie didn't have courage to ask him to accompany her home because the writer was a stranger, she was poor, she was afraid of her mother, the writer was unfriendly. The correct answer is the writer was a stranger. Question number 9. How do you do? The writer said, to know Mrs. Bethy's health, to know Mrs. Bethy's financial condition, to know Mrs. Bethy's occupation, to greet Mrs. Bethy being introduced. The correct answer is to greet Mrs. Bethy being introduced. Really, you should know that whenever you are being introduced to an unknown person, you should greet the person saying, how do you do? And its answer should be, how do you do? Okay, now come to question number 10. Mrs. Bethy's hands were covered with dash, soil, flour, dust, dirt. As she was making cake, her hands were covered with flour. Right? Question number 11. Mrs. Bethy was making cakes to dash. Send her son to feed her daughter, to celebrate her birthday, to sell in her neighborhood. Easy answer, to sell in her neighborhood. Question number 12. Saturday dash was the time of festivity in the neighborhood. Can you tell the time, correct time? Midnight, night, evening or afternoon? The correct answer is night. Right? Question number 13. Where was he? The old man asked happily, angrily, eagerly, politely. You know, when Maggie called her mother, when Maggie said her mother that an Indian has come to meet you, she wanted to know about him eagerly. So correct answer is here, eagerly. Question number 14. The writer's second meeting with the girl was dash, by chance, arranged, pre-planned, by invitation. Correct answer is pre-planned. The writer on the very first day decided to meet the girl on next Saturday. That's why it was pre-planned. Question number 14. All things are sold dash that night of festivity on, in, at, with. This is about a preposition. So this is about a particular occasion. So we should use here option A, on. Question number 16. Maggie had dash family members. 3, 2, 4, 5. So the question is perhaps confusing for you. You should know that Maggie, her mother and her brother. So total number of family is 3. So answer is 3. Question number 18. Maggie was dash an orphan, fatherless, motherless, brotherless. So correct answer is Maggie was fatherless. Question number 19. The writer was dash on hearing about the poor girl, saddened, shocked, surprised, moved. All answers seem to be correct, but actual vocabulary is moved. The writer was moved on hearing about the girl. Question number 20. Maggie said, an Indian has come to dash you, inform you, see you, help you, call you. The answer is to see you. Okay. Question number 21. The writer held out his hands to dash, to clean Mrs. Bethy's hand, to help Mrs. Bethy make cakes, for a cake to taste, to shake hands with Mrs. Bethy. Correct answer is option D, to shake hands with Mrs. Bethy. Okay. Now come to question number 22. How did Maggie's family make their living? By selling toys, by selling sweets, by working in a hotel, by selling cakes. So correct answer once again, that is option D, by selling cakes. Question number 23. The writer's curiosity about the girl persisted. Here persisted means dash, continue to exist, continue to increase, continue to decrease, discontinue to exist. So the answer is continue to exist. Question number 24. During festivities, the people are able to spend dash from their weekly wages, a lot, maximum, a little, and last answer more. Correct answer is a little. Okay. Question number 25. who did Maggie live with? Her parents, her brother, her sister, her parent. So you see here two options seem to be correct. Her parents and her parent. As her father was dead, she lived with one parent. So answer is her parent, option D. Okay, so this is about part 1 MCQ. Thank you for watching this video, and very soon I am going to present you the second part of the video of this chapter, which will be very helpful for you for your summative assessment. Thank you.